So the moral science, chapter 3, we have discussed about humility, humble person, okay, sensibility and all those points we have already discussed. Now whatever is given in your book is that some examples of humility. What you will do is that you just go through these stories about Rajinikanth, Dilip Kumar and the Sheila Ghosh, okay. So just go through about this, nothing to hear more, no and all, just go through all this examples, and here two stories has given that we'll read out, and from that somebody or what the story wants to tell us, that we have to prepare. Okay, so let us read the first one. Okay, the pencil and the notebook. It's a lesson in humility, all related with humility, clear? But from this story what we come to know, that in a gist, a brief form, we'll just summarize, clear? So once there was a pencil and a notebook. "Hey Puni, I'm huge compared to you," said the notebook. The pencil was angry. He thought of ways he could be better than the notebook. Usually like that only. Then he spoke up. "I can make your paper messy." So she also started. The notebook was silent. Then he said to the pencil, "I last a long time, but you get short." So both are actually humiliating each other. But at last, what is going? "Well, I come in packets of 50, but you come single," said the pencil. "People use me for school," said the notebook. Then again, pencil is saying, "They use me for school too." Then the notebook and pencil realized that they were made together, made to go together. "We are both as good as each other," they said. In this quickly little tale of the pencil and the notebook, there is nothing from selfishness or empty conceit. But with humility of mind, regard one another as more important than yourself. So here both of them, first of all, is humanizing that each other, is it? First he is saying, "I am the superior one, I am coming like that, I am more superior than you, I am coming in 50 numbers, you are single, I can make you messy." He said, "You are going shorter day by day, I will be the same only." So these are, both are actually cursing each other, but at last they come to know that both they are using for the same purpose, and both are actually made to go together only. So how they realize the humility of their self is actually realize them that they are made to go together. So the realization of this is known as humility of mind, clear? Humility of mind. So the first story, in a gist form, you will write first that how they are cursing each other, and after that how they realize their humility and all, humbleness and all. Clear? What is there in the next story? Let's see. The heavy log. Once upon a time, a rider came across a few soldiers who were trying to move a heavy log of wood without success. So they are trying to move that heavy log, but they cannot. The corporal was standing by just watching as the men struggle. So corporal, another one, he's just standing there and watching them how they are walking. The rider couldn't believe it. Cannot understand why the corporal is standing there only, not helping. He finally asked the corporal why he was not helping. The corporal replied, "I am the corporal, I give orders." So this is known as cruelness. The corporal only said that, "I was made for only orders. I cannot do any work, so I am not helping them." The rider said nothing in response. He didn't say anything. Instead, he dismounted his horse. From his words, he get off. He went up and stood by the soldiers, and as they tried to lift the wood, and he helped them. So he is helping them, that rider helping them. With his help, the task was finally able to be carried out. So with the help of three, see, two are doing that work and the log was heavy, cannot do the work properly. So while the rider helped them, ultimately they complete their work. Who was this kind rider? Who was this? The rider was George Washington, the commander-in-chief, superior than that corporal. He quietly mounted his horse and went to that corporal and said, "The next time your men need help, send for the commander-in-chief." He said, "Next time whenever they will need some war help from, just call me. I will do for this." So it is just humbleness. It doesn't matter how superior you are from others. It doesn't matter which place you are. The humbleness should be there always within you. That humility actually sent that commander in chief to help them to do the work properly so that they can complete their work. Okay, so that is only these two stories. Just go through the stories and, as I said, summarize briefly about how you can get that point, humility here, humbleness and all. Okay, so gist of these two stories. And another project work is written here. It is the between humility and pride, there is any difference or not, that you will write in your copy. Clear? This one project is homework, write in the copy. Okay, till then just divide this chapter, nothing is there more about the humility, and these two stories briefly summarize. Okay, thank you class.